blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Good evening and welcome to St. Joseph's. This weekend, we are celebrating the third Sunday of Advent. Our opening song is number 38, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel. Please rise as we welcome Father Gene Murphy.
Lord our God, we praise you for your Son, Jesus Christ. He is Emmanuel, the hope of the peoples. He is the wisdom that teaches and guides us. He is the Savior of every nation. Lord God, let your blessing come upon us as we light the candles of this wreath. May the wreath and its light be a sign of Christ's promise to bring us salvation. May he come quickly and not delay. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Good evening. We really must remember the people who are suffering from the tornadoes in our southern states. The last I saw was that over 50 people had been killed, and so many other people have been just devastated. Whole towns seem to have been wiped out. And let's be grateful for what we have here in Amory, and let's ask God's blessing on those poor people. We gather in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you always. As we prepare to celebrate these mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God bless us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who see how your people faithfully await the feast of the Lord's Nativity, enable us, we pray, to attain the joys of so great a salvation and to celebrate them always with solemn worship and glad rejoicing. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Are the lights as bright as they should be? Or am I going blind? Should they be lighter? Sorry. Never mind.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Shout for joy, O daughter Zion. Sing joyfully, O Israel. Be glad and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has removed the judgment against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You have no further misfortune to fear. On that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, fear not, O Zion, be not discouraged. The Lord your God is in your midst, a mighty Savior. He will rejoice over you with gladness and renew you in his love. He will sing joyfully because of you, as one sings at festivals. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Joy and gladness for among you. thanks to the Lord. Proclaim his name. Among the nations make known his deeds. Proclaim how exalted is his name. Cry out with joy and gladness, for among you is the great and holy one of Israel. Sing praise to the Lord for his glorious achievement. Let this be known throughout all the earth. Shout with exultation, O city of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. Cry out with joy and gladness, for among you is the great and holy One of Israel.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice. Your kindness should be known to all. The Lord is near. Have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The crowds asked John the Baptist, "What should we do?" He said to them in reply, "Whoever has two cloaks should share with the person who has none, and whoever has food should do likewise." Even tax collectors came to be baptized, and they said to him, "Teacher, what should we do?" He answered them, "Stop collecting more than what is prescribed." Soldiers also asked him, "And what is it that we should do?" He told them, "Do not practice extortion. Do not falsely accuse anyone, and be satisfied with your wages." Now the people were filled with expectation, and all were asking in their hearts whether John might be the Christ. John answered them all, saying, "I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you in the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his barn. But the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." Exhorting them in many other ways, he preached good news to the people. the gospel of the Lord. During Advent, it's really appropriate that we read a lot of Gospels about John the Baptist. He is utterly unique among prophets. He was kind of a wild man. He lived in the desert, and that was extremely unusual. You know, I mean, the desert was a desperately dangerous place. There were wild animals. There were criminals, robbers, and murderers everywhere. He was unique among the prophets because he had a real sense of urgency in his preaching. When he talked about the coming of Christ, he talked as if it was going to be within the next month or two. The prophets of old, that came centuries before him, talked about Christ when he came. They talked about it would be a long time from now, but we still had to be prepared. He talked a lot about an impending judgment and its consequent punishment. He consecrated so much on the punishments. He talked about the way people... The Apostle Luke, the evangelist Luke, used a literary device where people would ask questions, and the questions were designed to give teachings. He said that tax collectors asked him what they should do, and tax collector in that job, in that time, was a really great job. I mean, Rome would tell the tax collector how much he would collect from a certain village or a town. And he would collect that, but he'd collect more, you know, maybe 50% more or 100% more, and he would keep the remainder, and he would just give to Rome what they required. Soldiers also said, what should we do? And soldiers were brutal people. I mean, they're not like soldiers today. They were utterly uneducated. They didn't know right from wrong. All they knew was when somebody says to kill somebody, I kill them. And it was a difficult job, but also they did very nicely financially because they would simply take whatever they wanted from the people of the towns and villages where they were stationed. God gives us talents. Everyone here, everyone in the world has a certain talent, sometimes several of them. And these sometimes are used by these people as opportunities to enrich themselves and to abuse poorer people or helpless people. The talents we are given at birth should be used to serve others. If you can imagine God creating our world, especially the human part of it, he wanted the world to be a paradise, an absolute paradise. And it should be. Unfortunately, people use their talents for all the wrong things. To build houses that they can't, a size they can't possibly use. And if you have a beautiful home, I think that's great. But is it enough? And that's the question that I think Jesus Christ wanted us to ask on a regular basis. Is it enough? Can I use my talents to serve other people? I was given the talent, if you can call it that, that I'm not reluctant to stand up in front of a bunch of people and talk. I would wish I had the talent to make sense. That would be really great, you know? But I do what I do. And I try to use it in the service of the people assigned to me by Almighty God. It's just, in the time of Christ, wealth was always considered to be gathered it through dishonesty. It was a common thought that it was impossible for an honest person to be wealthy. And I don't think that's true. I don't think it was true then, and I don't think it's true now. But if you have been fortunate, and we all have, we're living in Amory, Wisconsin, and that is a gift. Understand, God has given you a gift, and you must ask, why did he give this to me? Why? Who can I serve with the talents that I have, with the treasure that I have? This is an important question. It truly is. God bless you all. Let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. True God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As one community, let us send up our prayers and petitions to Almighty God.
For our participation in the mission of Christ, that through our synodal journey together, we may grow in our shared responsibility of the mission that is entrusted to us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the whole church, that we will let God sing his song of love over us today, refusing to let any discordant notes into the beautiful music of redemption, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That like John the Baptist, we may humbly proclaim the majesty of our Savior by the witness of our lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are discouraged, hungry, lonely, homeless, sick, or grieving, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish cluster, for whom this Mass is offered, that we may draw water with joy at the fountain of salvation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, hear and grant these petitions. We ask in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives forever and ever. I don't think we have any children to call up, but okay.
Feed us now.
Pray, my friends, that your sacrifice and mine will be acceptable to Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the sacrifice of our worship, Lord, we pray, be offered to you unceasingly to complete what was begun in sacred mystery and powerfully accomplish for us your saving work through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, James, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her holy spouse, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Please join our communion song, number 50, Waiting in Silence, number 50.
Bishop James has asked us to read this prayer at the end of Mass, not with the other intentions. So for those of you who have it, let's say it together. We stand before you, Holy Spirit, as we gather together in your name, with you alone to guide us, make yourself at home in our hearts. Teach us the way we must go and how we are to pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not let us promote disorder. Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path, nor partiality influence our actions. Let us find in you our unity, so that we may journey together to eternal life and not stray from the way of truth and what is right. All this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time, in the communion of the Father and the Son, forever and ever. Thank you. To go over the Christmas Mass schedule here at St. Joseph, Friday night, December 24th, we have a Mass here at 4 p.m. The next morning, Christmas morning, December 25th, we have a 10:30 Mass here, just like the Sunday schedule. And then the next day, the 26th, it is a Sunday, and we have the Sunday schedule once again at 8:30 that morning. That's what I said, 10:30. You guys think you're so smart, don't you? I am really a wreck, you know that? If you can volunteer for the ice fishing contest chicken dinner here in our gathering area, not the gathering area, fellowship hall, there is a sign-up sheet in the back of the gathering space that has the time and the date on that that sign-up sheet. And if you would be generous with your time to the extent that you can. This Wednesday evening, there will be a reconciliation service open for all. Examination of conscience will begin at 6:30, and there will be two priests available to hear confessions. Two priests, no waiting. Let us pray. We implore your mercy, Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feast through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Please join in our closing song, number 387, God Has Chosen Me. We'll do verse 1 and 3.